Degrowth, it's a new political, citizen, intellectual, and also a civil society movement. It started like more than 10 years ago in France. First, it's a provocative slogan. I don't know whether it makes sense in English, but in France it was décroissance, and it was used first by somebody coming from marketing as this type of semantic tool with the idea that we should question why we always speak about economic growth. As soon as we face one problem in the society, the only political, economic, or intellectual answer, it's always growth, 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 growth. And even if it's a word which is very often criticized because it's not so much federative, it's quite a negative meaning. Why do we speak about degrowth in time of recession, of rising inequalities, unemployment and everything? I think it's a very interesting tool to really, really question a lot of implicit beliefs what we have in our society, to question the fact that we live on a planet which is called the Earth, and this planet has some limits what we cannot just overpass like that, like what we face with climate change, with scarcity of resources, with biodiversity loss, so all these physical limits to growth. And also it questions what we call the cultural limits to growth. The fact that we live in societies which are over-consuming, which are very rich materially, but I would say quite poor, humanly or culturally, socially, and even more if we consider how much violence we face, how unmeaningful life people are facing, rising inequalities, and all these type of things that we want to connect and put together. So degrowth is really to question all these addictions to growth, what we can call growth mania, from psychological, cultural addictions, but also institutional, economic addictions to growth, what we have, which makes this economic system that if you don't have growth, you collapse, whether you are an individual, a state, small company, a corporation and everything. We are in an economic system like that. And how we can implement step-by-step transitions, what we consider which must be serene, must be democratic, and transition to new models of society. But I think it's a very interesting point in it, because first, degrowth is a long path. It's a path of decolonization of our imaginary. It's a path to question, take distance to all the social pressure, all the belief what we have all around our society, because we grew up in this model of society, and to question centrality of economics. Was it always like that? If we look at history of civilization, does it really make me happy to be always profit-oriented or always more individualistic? This pressure to always consume more, to work more, to consume more and everything, does it really make me happy and so on? So all this idea to question ourselves, to reappropriate free time, meaningful life, do house, tools, to reappropriate a new economic system and so on. And the second reason why I think it's an interesting provocative slogan or tools, it's because it cannot be emptied from its content. We could see how in the last decade the awareness around green issues was totally emptied from its content, and nowadays the biggest polluters, the big corporations, are able to sell you whatever they want in the name of green, sustainable, so you can buy a wonderful air ticket to spend a weekend in Tunisia in an air-conditioned palace in the name of sustainable development, or you can buy a green car, you can buy whatsoever. And we live in this society dominated by marketing, so manipulation and lies, and it will be more difficult for this type of reappropriation to empty degrowth from its content. So it has this value when we should always question what do we produce, how do we produce it, for what kind of use. Very often also here, when you listen to mainstream media or mainstream economics, we will speak about the environmental crisis or climate change and everything. And just after, we will speak about the social crisis or economic crisis. And immediately you start to have some contradiction, because to solve one of the crises, they say we should consume less or produce less and everything. And to face the second one, they say, yeah, but we need growth to solve the problem of rising inequalities and unemployment and everything. And after you face problem of democracy, that nobody believes anymore in the politician, because for decades they keep saying that I will bring growth, 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 and in our Western societies there is no growth anymore. So we try to connect all these things. to construct another narrative, another understanding, and to understand that we are not facing different type of crisis, but we are facing a crisis of civilization. We are facing a crisis of a model which is unsustainable, which is full of contradiction, and a belief that always more will be enough to have meaningful life and everything. So degrowth is now like an international movement, where it's been translated into a lot of languages. And what is very interesting in being more and more international in the logic of convergence between different trends, different movements, different culture, different background and everything, that we really have this type of open movement where not everybody is having this label degrowth, and I think it's very good, it's very important to have a diversity of labels, of flags, of narrative, of experimentation and everything. But this type of network where everybody is somehow interconnected or more and more interconnected with each other, and we bring some discussion where we enrich the thinking, the experiments, the experience and so on.